and be able to climb back up again. We're about to see in this game number two, as again, we're going to feature some surprise picks. The Chaos Knight coming back as the clear counter to the Huskar.
Yeah, it's going to be one of the better heroes to deal with Fnatic's lineup just because they don't have that best way to deal with all those illusions. That's why they decided to gamble on the Ember Spirit by mid one, but at the same time, it might just not be enough as you need a lot of damage to deal with them.
Yes, you absolutely do. The Chaos Knight already natural in heavy amount of strength. You're going to need so much damage to clear through those illusions, but then you've got even worse, the Shadow Demon backing up. So that's going to be potentially even more illusions that are going to be thrown all over the field. And let's not forget the Kunkka Boat that's going to be coming in, making sure that everyone is even tankier when they go for that engagement. And then the Beastmaster Aura is going to be a nice upgrade in damage as well.
Fnatic going to move out, and this Huskar, it was meant to be their surprise pick to throw DC off, but I think DC kind of did the same with this Chaos Knight, and now we see DC. They're going to go for this bottom rune. Misery up in this top area. Misery, this playmaker so far for DC in the early game, has made everything possible for them so far, leading this young squad into a top four berth, and he wants to push it even further. They are one game away from entering the final day, and there is nobody that has that on their brackets.
On the other side, Fnatic, you said that in the beginning when we were watching this draft, the Elder Titan faces Void, probably one of the strongest openers. Does that offset what has been a very clear later in the draft counter with the Chaos Knight pick?
It does some of it, just because this combination has to be top three in Dota right now. You have a lot of different setups with this Faceless Void, with this Earth Splitter, the Echo Stomp. There's just a lot of different ways to synergize. On top of that, because of the Chronosphere, you have the Spirit in there at all times. You're going to deal so much damage within it, almost always going to kill somebody as DC. They're going to make a move all the way around mid one. He's going to get sandwiched.
They had four heroes down. They showed up until the last second and smoked up and will be able to
dodge
the first blood. The Sleight of Fist dodges a lot of damage, but he's getting body blocked up by Misery. Can they stay ahead of him? He's trying to get in front. DJ gives the extra movement.
That was incredible.
Beautiful pickup level Sleight of Fist to dodge the torrent and speeds himself away ahead of Digital Chaos' attempt at first blood.
And Resolution opting to go for the Reality Rift first. Mid one, quick thinking there as he barely manages to dodge that torrent. That was unbelievable.
Things getting even worse as Zoxa gonna take a lot of damage here from 343, caught out by himself. The full aggro tri-lane is gonna come out from Digital Chaos. They may try and go onto this Elder Titan. No, they're gonna leave him be for now, but they will have this nice disruption torrent combination with the Chaos Knight to be able to follow it up. Our middle lane, though, is going to be a bit harder for DC. Invoker is going to be matched up against the Ember Spirit and what could be the Wizard, but for now, he's going to go top, it looks like. They may be able to sandwich Misery, get some damage out on him. I think they just want to secure this Huskar lane, as we've seen in the past. Again, some Drow Ranger lineups, and especially Huskar. If you don't have the counter to the hero in the mid-game, you need to make sure that you pressure him in the laning phase as best as possible.
Yeah, this is a very good way to do it, but at the same time, Fnatic, they've got a decent lineup to battle back this Elder Titan. Able to get into these right-click fights in Soxa. They don't have this kill potential quite yet, and now they're going to go on DJ.
Disruption, Torrent follow-up. DJ's already down to half HP, actually just a stun, and they will be able to finish him off. They don't even need the Torrent. Being faked out now as Mushi dropped quite low as well. He's got a good backup of regeneration. Looks like he wants to keep himself just on that borderline where he's got the extra attack speed, but is still tanking enough to survive. Soxa, he's making a run here, managed to pick up his boots. He needs the help of his team though, because he was getting sandwiched, but this is going to turn against
a lot of spears.
Resolution, a lot of spears burning him down tick by tick. He has to heal himself, but it may not still be enough. 4 HP, and now he goes. Soxa, he moved forward for the boots and ends up baiting his own core into death.
You cannot push that far out. This Huskar deals so much damage in the early phases of the game. Level 2 Burning Spears now. And for DC to win this lane definitively, they have to get kills. But it's going to be hard. The counter initiation from this Huskar, if you don't immediately burst somebody down, he is going to grab a kill for himself.
DC will return with their aggro tri lane. Try and rest control of this lane once again. We haven't talked about the bottom lane too much. We'll briefly glimpse down there, but I'm sure there's going to be action top soon. Mu is matching up against Ohio's Faceless Void. It should be a
going to make a play for
matchup.
This.
There's the disruption, the torrent coming out. There is going to be a tether heal. 343 should be fine.
And they want to continue to try to make these aggressive moves up here. As Fnatic, they're going to start pressing forward. Here comes the stomp.
Stomp. Not quite latching there. DC now have the option to go on 343 to side against it. Resolution holds on to that Chaos Bolt, knowing that his mana is the biggest limiter in this lane. One Chaos Bolt is going to make him burn through a Mako. He's only got one of those.
And the unfortunate news is that DJ also has a tether available, and he's got one more bottle charge and a fairy fire to go. It's going to be very hard for DC to immediately burst down any of these heroes without losing somebody in return. So Fnatic going to secure up this top lane. Now, mid one. There is a regen rune at bottom. Unbeknownst to him is we just going to continue to farm away. But so far, laning phase has been all Fnatic.
The 4-minute rune going to be contested by the two supports on both sides. Spirit already going out, increasing the right-click damage of 3-4-3. Is he going to try and battle out?
Be careful.
The Torrent dodge is there. They start going for the disruption onto DJ. He picks up the bounty rune, but it's going to be caught by Fnatic still. Now they're going to try and turn this one around. Sunstrike, oh, beautiful mid one. Dancing around the edge of that one, but it's not going to be enough for him to escape unless the Firefire is enough. One more right-click. Oh, no, it's not enough. He gets this. Board Spirit finds it in the end. 3-2 now is Fnatic. They lost their Ember Spirit and their Wisp in exchange for the Kunkka. Clearly a trade that is not worth it for them.
They desperately needed something like that, especially after that build. First blood attempt. This laning phase hasn't gone exactly great for them as Mu getting bullied out of this bottom lane by Ohio. Faceless Void, one of the best melee 1v1 traders.
And it's all about the micro for Mu. He's got to keep that war constantly harassing Ohio, but also staying one step away from the Faceless Void, making sure he doesn't give away any extra gold. Now he's going to TP back to base. He does have his level 6, and we may see the first gank come out. Mihan going to be gone on by mid 1. Mid 1 is relying on the flame guard quite heavily, but
I just go down
damage,
here.
It may overwhelm him. He's got some battle charge. Will have to use both the battle charge as well as that healing salve to be able to keep himself alive. Weeha also similarly just on the edge there.
I think if we turned half a second earlier, he probably would have been able to get that kill. But he got scared, and he doesn't have mana for the Sunstrike quite yet. We, the type of player to still go for it.
Gotta go for it. Oh, you know it. You know he is mid one. He's gonna light by the throne, invoker, not throwing out the Sunstrike.
He's
not gonna go for it. He doesn't have enough information.
Yeah, that would have been completely blind. Play of the game kind of stuff, but he's content to farm right now. He's zoned out the Ember Spirit very well by himself, and I think he's going to be relatively satisfied. But the other lanes right now, this is causing concern for Fnatic, as Mushi just continues to farm up, and DC really can't contest them. They have to be content to just let Resolution farm in this lane, and Mushi going to come back now. Already has the Helm of Iron Will and that Magic Stick.
It's hard to see how Digital Chaos will actually be able to deal with this Huskar now. Now that he's got those higher levels, it's so dangerous if they don't actually combo him fully correctly. And even then, there's still the possibility that the Wisp keeps him alive. Huskar can turn a fight. There's crazy output of damage from those burning spears. We'll have to see if Digital Chaos are going to take that risk as they continue to run this tri-lane, giving Mu plenty of space at the bottom lane to get some farm. He's even using some of the neutrals now to keep in step with Ohio. But as you said earlier, Ohio is still the Faceless Void, one of the best one-on-one matchups. He is taking an early lead in CS.
Right now, Mu has to do whatever he can just to trade somewhat evenly. But still, this Void, level 7, maxed out, Bash almost. He wants to try to look for any sort of signs of aggression as Mu. Can't really do much. Even if somebody rotates down here, they probably don't have enough damage to take down this Void. That was an HP on him. No burst on the side of DC. Maybe if they pair with the Sunstrike, but it doesn't look like they want to go for any plays. And they're trying to still set up for top. This should be a high enough level of Sunstrike where maybe they can burst somebody down without the Huskar responding.
3-4-3, maybe the target here. He's the one putting himself on the front lines. Digital Chaos Not going to go for it just yet. Our mid lane matchup, it was going really well for mid one in the beginning of the game. Despite it being a one-on-one and not actually having the Wisp there to protect him, he was getting a very big lead on the Invoker in CS. That is, up until that top river engagement, where he ended up going down to the rotations from Digital Chaos, and then that last attempt on Weeha's life also put him back at CS as well. He's trying to recover now, does have his level 7, so he's hit a certain peak, and may be able to go for a kill if he gets any kind of rotation to help out with the Invoker.
Fnatic just pushing out this top lane. They've almost got this armlet on this Huskar. And once they have that, they can start to snowball pretty hard. Roshan's a possibility for them as well as DC. It's going to be tough for them to contest that, especially with their CK so underfarmed as Mu again forced to resort to the jungle as Ohio's going to pick up a very quick Vlad's, and this might be a very strong 5-man lineup for Fnatic.
Ember Spirit. Midwan's already set himself up with a really nice defensive remnant over there above that top rune spawn area. So Midwan isn't going to be caught out by this rotation. In fact, he's going to use the haste to go down to the bottom lane, see if he can get the solo farmer, and sure enough, they will be able to get him. Oh, they do have the Chronosphere, but Max TP is coming in, and with an Ember Spirit, he can't really do much about that Chronosphere, so I think Midwan had a different plan in mind. He wanted to be able to get close range with Mu, start letting that flame guard eat into Mu's HP, but the Chronosphere kind of keeps him zoned out, and DZ respond with a complete rotation of their Triumph.
Yeah, and that was a very awkward engagement for Fnatic.
Whoa, pull him back there.
Had to use that Chrono, but still in an okay position as this Faceless Void has gotten so much out of the map already.
That Hawk is so far off the map, you can't even see him, but that was what was giving vision of Ohio. Ohio still trying to see if he can contest this Tier 1 tower push. He's got a lot of allies coming in, but he has no Chronosphere. The Tier 1 tower dies before Fnatic can respond.
Yeah, and that tower being taken down, very good for DC as Fnatic did rotate quite a lot of heroes here. But up at top again, the bigger threat looms as Mushi's Huskar continues to sit back and farm. The good news for DC though is that they have completed this Midas on this Invoker, and now this Beastmaster has jumped out to a lead. Almost has that Necrobook 1. It's going to be very effective in shutting down the Void as you can burn through his mana quite quickly.
Mid 1's got himself an
Oh, I bought him. Jump.
And
go for it.
He'll be able to get the stun. 2 seconds down with the Sun Strike and the Torrent follow up. It's going to burst Ohio pretty low. He needs a bit more time for that time watch. It doesn't look like he's going to get it. Pulled back by X marks the spot. Mushi not there quite yet to be able to hit that ultimate. Zoxa turns around, does manage to get off the disruption, preventing the leap of a life break. Mushi, he's got that armlet. No one really wants to fight this Huskar unless they've got a complete airtight plan to fight him.
Yeah, he's not going to be easy to take down, especially with the Wisp that can wait in the wings and TP down. Doesn't have a TP quite yet, and Mu gonna pop the Necrobooks by taking this tower.
Chaos Knight not sticking at that bottom lane. He heads up the top right as the Tier 1 tower is about to fall. Mid 1 is going to make his reveal there with the Invisible. Starts going on to Mu. Resolution is going to be coming in from the side. The Sunstrike actually takes out DJ. Here's another Resolution. On to Mid 1. They do pop that ultimate. Chaos Knight's going to try and beat down Mid 1 as best as possible. The ultimate going down from 3-4-3. Not going to be fast enough to be able to pull Resolution back. They're going to try and chase him down. But here comes the Shatter Demon. The Sun going to be required here. Resolution a little bit more. Disruption ready to go. Prevents the Elder Titan from pursuing out. He tries to go for a spear here. Not going to be enough. 25 HP. Resolution stays one step ahead. Zoxa, he's saving if they get the Sunstrike.
No!
The Sunstrike was on the mark. Mid 1 will barely survive, though.
Oh, if he was able to get that poison off, that would have been enough. That was 280 damage. Even with the reduction, Mid 1 would have died. But the Shadow Demon can't pop it when you're dead.
That just means Ember Spirit able to get back to base, heals himself up, pops the Flame Guard even, just to make sure when poison times out, he stays alive. Now Mu, they seem to be constantly moving the tri-lane and Mu around, switching sides. Mu was just top, took the Tier 1 tower. That gank attempt now allows him to head bottom.
And now Mid 1, gonna show back up mid. He still has a decent amount of net worth. This Invoker though, While all that was happening top, he just continues to farm out his own jungle, playing that very passive style. This is not a hero that you necessarily want to teamfight with. Although that may surprise some people, Invoker, the cooldown on this Invoke is so long that at best you get two abilities, both of them can't really teamfight. The better thing to do is look for these 2v2 engagements where you can help out with the Sunstrike across the map, and we can just continue to farm. You don't want to farm, really get into an engagement before you have at least the Agnes Scepter.
Smoke rotation from Fnatic right now. Currently trying to scout out behind
Radiant's
tier 1 in the bottom lane.
Attack.
Even hoping that someone's going to TP and try and stop Mushi from pushing forward. Not going to be the case here. The trap is a failure. Digital Chaos are going to sacrifice their
Radiant's
safe lane tower in exchange for keeping this game very low risk.
DC pushing out this top lane. In real good position right now, as this Invoker and Resolution's finally starting to pick up some farm. The Beastmaster doing very well for himself, almost already has the book too if he wants it, as Ohio might even be the target here. We talked about how much burst they have with these Necro Creeps.
They can get the Primal Roar. They're actually going to leave with the Torrent. They will now blow up the Primal
Mana
Roar.
Mana burn them
and bump the Sunstrike. It will be enough. They explode. The Faceless Void. Ohio goes down. And now Digital Chaos will take back control of their own jungle.
Very well done by them, as now Fnatic trying to make their own move into this mid lane. Mid one finding the angle. Weehawk gonna get gone on.
He's gonna be chained up. Now the Elder Type ultimate should be able to snap him back as well. And with the extra bit of damage for the Spirits and the Flame Guard, they'll catch Weehawk inside the river. Ghost walked up, but still falls to the AoE.
Even without detection, like you said, enough burn damage to cut through him is very good rotation, but that was the first time we saw the Invoker position that aggressively, and they punished it so well, as this Ember Spirit has just been everywhere on the map. And the key thing is he still managed to keep up and farm his Resolution, just gonna scare him a little bit and force him to jump back.
Doesn't even have any backup in that top lane. Resolution is entirely alone. Doesn't even have the armlet, but is playing so confidently that Fnatic probably thinking twice about what heroes are behind him. DC, though, are actually running more of that two-man squad that you were talking about. With, looks like Misery Moo gonna link up once again. The Torrents leading into the Primal Roar as a surprise gank, or even more secured, the Primal Roar into a Torrent. It's a great combination.
Mint!
You saw that combination, Mint. Used on a Wisp Illusion.
Moo gonna be incredibly disappointed with that. Attack. Although he didn't pop the Necro Books, but still, that minute-long cooldown, Fnatic gonna try to get aggressive, and they really need to utilize this Huskar. It feels like Mushi a little bit too content to get into this farm war, but you want to try to use this hero to try to take down objectives, use him as a frontliner, especially with this Wisp, and now they're gonna start to do so, as Mushi dragging himself mid.
He's got Armlet, he's got Dragonlands, which will allow him to siege down these towers a bit better. Maybe that's why Fnatic, oh, they're gonna find the Chronosphere behind the tier 1 tower. Soxa will be the target here. He'll be blown up, but Torrent as well as the boat lands on Mushi. They do have that inner vitality going up, and Mushi should be fine to start hitting on that tier 1 tower. DC not fully committed to a fight just yet, but will start pushing forward.
And right now, this mid lane not really quite defensible, as they're not really looking to get into an engagement. DC just looking to push the creep wave back, continue to farm, get some items on their heroes. As again, Fnatic gotta play around this Huskar at all costs.
Somebody lit the Shadow Demon, get some levels. He's level 5 at 17 minutes in.
This might be one of the later timings I've ever seen.
Yeah.
The weird thing is he still has more net worth than this Elder Titan.
He's just playing this very sacrificial hard 5 role, but
is he? He's got arcane boots and a wand, man.
Maybe just an experienced Mushi. The Sunstrike, pure damage, and the physical damage of Resolution's ult in combination will bring down the Huskar.
We're gonna see this Wisp relocate come in as well. They might be able to just grab another kill. DC gathered around this ball of light.
They are gonna get the tether, put the pull back.
They are not going to let it shine as they continue to push forward. Now walking into the Roche pit, Huskar and Wisp down without the relocate. This should be fast for DC, and this is the opening that they need to start taking control of the map.
Oh, Fnatic, it all starts falling apart. They had this Huskar, couldn't really use him to get any successful team fight, and then one mispositioning there leads him into a death in the mid lane, and it just snowballs so quickly. All of a sudden, thanks to the early Necronomicon by Mu, because DC bought him that kind of space, they have this pushing power where they can take down the tier 1 so quickly and transition into a Roshan kill.
That was a very fast Roshan. With all the summons, and on top of that, you've got Weeha, who deals a very good amount of damage with that Alacrity. They took that quite quickly, and Fnatic, they rely really heavily on that. Their Huskar doesn't have a hero like the Dazzle who can grave him. He's got the Wisp who, if he just gets blown up or DJ gets repelled, it's very easy to isolate this hero. They have tons of ways to deal with him. Plenty of minions, a lot of right-click damage in the form of their Chaos Knight with the Inner Beast. This is not a hero that is invincible in a game like this. So Fnatic, they're finally going to start playing around their Huskar for resolution or ready out.
It's just too late. They already have the aggressive vision down. You saw that ward being placed up earlier while they were in the Roshan pit. That helped give them the information of Fnatic's rotation down to bottom lane. They're hoping to be able to fight that Chaos Knight, especially while he still doesn't have Phantasm. But they're not able to abuse this long cooldown. Again, just failing to be able to latch onto a team fight or a gank that they're looking for. Now Mushi may be caught here. DJ ready to go with the relocate. Oh, no! Oh, that timing, and he disrupted Mushi. There was no target for the Wisp to relocate out. And all of a sudden, Mushi comes back, surrounded by Digital Chaos Heroes. And it looks like DJ going to be sacrificed as well. He was hiding in the trees as he came back from that relocate. Couldn't TP away fast enough.
And Fnatic just not reading that situation correctly is, you cannot save the CK under those situations. Stoxa, very good disruption, outplaying that Wisp right there. But Fnatic, this is the lineup that was meant to get into these engagements. They've got a Faceless Void, an Elder Titan, Huskar, a very immobile hero. You want to start marching down lanes with this guy, and they haven't been able to do so, and instead, they're trying to play this split farm game. And DC, their team fight is just too strong. They push so quickly. Fnatic have to do something to respond.
Now, while there is finally the Ember Spirit picking up the battle here, it looks like Misery is taking a page out of Lanham's book and will be able to pick up an armlet for his Kunkka. It's level 10, he's got Phase Boots as well, maxed out Tidebringer, as well as X. This is very rapidly turning into a fourth core for Digital Chaos.
Yeah, and it's pretty incredible to say, but net worth-wise, he's not even that far behind Mushi. Maybe if they win one team fight and they get a tower, he'll be pretty close. And Mushi, he's got to force his team to fight around him. They've got to start making moves. It looks like they're reluctant to with the Aegis, but in this mid lane, mid one, gonna get opened up on.
He can't really do much here besides the sleight of fist. The X marks the spot, not able to pull him back at the right time. Fortunately, there was a lot of targets there for the sleight of fist, so it was a stalled out and vulnerability period for that Ember Spirit. He makes zip away.
And this Huskar, getting camped by DJ, but once again,
they know about this. Again, DJ sitting here with the relocate. Not going in just yet. The Rush Strike coming in. The relocate will be just in time. Pulls him out. Ohio's going to be the target instead as he gets Primal Ward.
Oh, he didn't go that far.
Back into the play. Will start going on to Resolution. Takes a lot of physical damage, but now he jumps forward. Resolution is going to be his target. Turn around. 2 seconds done. That could be good enough. We hop. Deputy Blast pulling Mushi back into the Necronomicon. No! Armlet goes up. Mushi will survive. He's trapped inside the trees. It looks like he will go through all this. Meanwhile, Midwine catching up as the double kill will find a third. Misery. He tries to go for the turret. Oh, he gets the stun strike! The Feather's Blurt and Misery! He's doing it! He's already got the armlet toggle fighting out Midwine. Midwine kites him around, but it's long enough for Weeha to come back and
hold that cold snap! No, the cold snap stops the echo!
Now, Weeha looking for Weeha. Looking for Midwine in the trees. He's hiding away. He's got that battle.
There's only one more angle to find.
Sees him now. Midwine breaks around the Rosie into the trees. Glad he's been trying to dodge. Tornado!
That sun strike was a thing of beauty as Mushi gets caught off guard. We managing to save that fight from nothing as Misery bought so much time, but Ohio with the initiation, this should be able to grab him.
Some big time plays being made by Weeha here on the main stage, but that Chronosphere is definitely heavy commitment by Fnatic to cut Weeha's life down. They will be able to get that kill, and that was worth a lot too, about a 1600 gold swing there.
even without the Aghanims, that might have been one of the best combinations I've seen of Invoker spell usage. He cold snapped the Elder Titan at the last possible second, managing to catch him off guard. He runs down the Ember Spirit. So well done saving that fight. Otherwise, that could have been the turning point for Fnatic, as we see up at top.
I mean, this was such a clutch play. Misery, he tried to lay out a Torrent, mid one, read it correctly, but we didn't get a chance to talk about, but look at that. That toggle right there was beautiful. The Sunstrike lands on the Huskar, and Misery, even if he dies there, he survives long enough for Weeha to be able to come in and chase down mid one. Two players of Digital Chaos making extremely good plays there.
I don't even know what to talk about then. I just want to keep focusing on that Sunstrike, because that thing was unbelievable as Mu centered up at bottom mid. Maybe not the hero that he wants to go on. He does have that Roar available. Maybe he wants to use it with the Sunstrike, but he's got to be always worried about DJ.
With the extra health coming in from Weeha, he's already teeping into the hog, but he's kind of stuck into the trees. He doesn't have a blink yet, so he's kind of stuck there. And Mu, he thought he was going to get some extra health, but in fact, he's going to be run down. Mid-1 will be able to finish him off with a sleight of fist. Little do Fnatic know, Weeha is still here in the trees.
That was very odd. They were trying to do that aerial strike combo.
Yeah.
Maybe even would have gotten a kill, but
somebody missed micro the hog. That's got to be it. Either that, or he was planning on Mu to cut down the trees for him, but
that was a pretty big kill for them, too.
Oh, absolutely.
Now this Huskar going to gain a little bit more network. They can still continue to play around this hero cap. He is incredibly strong, and Fnatic, the best thing for them is this Void ET combo can still scale at any point in the game. DC, got to be careful for that. You're going to have to grab something like the Aether Lens on Soxa, so we can always get that destruction off, even with the Chrono in the way.
Yeah, with Ohio having that Blink Dagger, he could get the clutch kind of initiations. He doesn't really need to get
him. He's gonna just find a free kill.
Okay, it's gonna be the Chronosphere onto Soxa with the help of the Relocate. They should easily be able to pick up that one. That's a Relocate and a Chronosphere committed. Fortunately, the positioning of that gank does lead them straight to the mid tower. But a Glyph goes down, and Digital Chaos are actually here to defend.
Yeah, they want to fight this.
Weeha chasing down Mushi with the cold snap, jump board, isolation by Ohio. Did nobody build slow down these heroes? That's up there. 3-4-3 will be able to hit multiple heroes, but Weeha with a beautiful combination takes out Ohio. And now she's left alone to Mushi. Mushi's dead as well. The TP out, 3-4-3 will complete it. But that's 3-4 now. Gets him. He got him with the Sunstrike.
Every single time you click anywhere inside the base, it'll always send you right on top of that logo. Reads the Sunstrike perfectly. If you're gonna get away from that Invoker, you want a TP to the left of it, but instead, Weeha has fallen. Unbelievable Invoker performance, willing DC to this top three burn. They're gonna start pushing down mid with four heroes down. They're gonna take down this tower quite quickly, even with the Glyph in the way. Mid one, the only one left alive to defend this.
Unbelievable performance by Weeha so far. They're going to be attempted pushback here from mid one with his Battle Fury, but he just can't output enough damage. The melee rack falls, and mid one knows he needs to be able to catch someone. He's
they got him.
He tried to jump away. Now it's going to be confident for him. They're desperate to be able to make something come of this, but Fnatic just not grouped up. Now here comes Mushi, but all of Digital
they get the bash.
He
one hit
himself away. Okay, there's the stomp. They hit the Shadow Demon. Once again, Soxa will be left behind as his team escapes.
For the melee racks, though, well worth his life. And DC, you cannot underestimate how quickly they push. Fnatic, in these team fights, they just do not look centered whatsoever. And they thought because it was 4v5, DC were going to avoid that fight, but without the Chrono available, that's their major form of lockdown for this Huskar to be able to deal damage. And the Wisp was nowhere near him, went down very early.
Ohio's got the Chrono Sphere.
This is when you want to fight, if you're Fnatic.
No Shadow Demon disruption to be able to save the hero if they get the right kind of Chrono Sphere, but right now they just can't find the entrance. Board Spirits are blocking out this right side entrance to Ohio. He can't really sneak his way in.
Next, Roshan going to be absolutely massive for both teams. We saw time and time again, Mushi really needs that Aegis to be able to survive. Can't just rely on this Ball of Light. As DC, they take him down so quickly. DC, if they could get an Aegis onto somebody like Weeha, being able to refresh your spells twice in a fight might be enough to propel them, as Fnatic just grouped around this area. They want to fight because they have this Chronosphere. Might be one of their better opportunities with the vision game with this gem picked up.
the final series and potentially our final game to determine which one of these two teams is going to be heading into the last day of the International. It's 19-14, 27 and a half minutes in. Digital Chaos, one game up and 10,000 gold lead, 5,000 experience in game number two.
Yeah, and Fnatic, again, they're just trying to farm out whatever they can. They know where the real fight's going to happen as DC.
Poking around, they know Roshan, all important right now. That could be the way for Fnatic to be able to get back into this game off the momentum that an Aegis grants you. But you can see both sides contesting that Roshan pit as best as possible. The four versus the Raven's Creek. The four will finally win. Goes wide.
Over that?
Radiant's not too much else attack. Happening right now.
Take your spots, guys.
He's kind of pushing in the mid lane, but he can't really fully commit for a tier 1 tower push. If they go for that on Digital Chaos' side of the map and they lose that fight, they'll also lose control of Roshan, so both teams are just searching for an opening right now.
And Fnatic, centered around this Rosh Pit area, they absolutely cannot afford to give it up. They do have superior vision right now as a result of this gem on this void. This was going to be one of the only items that they could pick up to start turning things around, as the Hawk is going to do too much in the vision game. As they're going to smoke up now under complete vision. Maybe if they can get over here, DJ has that relocate available. It looks like Fnatic, maybe they want to find the angle to fight.
Sitting here on the high ground, they know this could be a funnel of death if they could give the right kind of earth splitter, but they choose not to take that engagement. They don't have all their heroes. Aegis fully back away.
Yeah, that might have been an opportunity for them, but they still feel like they're a little bit too far behind as DC gathered around this bottom area. No idea that they had smoked under that board vision as Fnatic. Maybe they go for a smoke of their own, and it looks like that's exactly what they're going to go for. They want to collapse right on top of DC. They know exactly where they are. Maybe if they can angle around fast enough, the line's been drawn. DC.
They see if they come in through this left-hand side, they could catch Weehaw's Invoker.
They're going to want to lead with this Faceless Void as Wee trying to be safe, but he doesn't know that the full wraparound is coming in. They've circled DC's position.
Oh, they start grouping up big time. This Chronosphere could be beautiful for Ohio. It's so important that Fnatic win this fight.
And now the
jump forward. There goes the Everspear. Getting some vision already. Ohio faking the Chronosphere. Will be able to latch onto once. And the Destruction Save is there. And Mushi, he's almost gone. Gets him over. He gets back in. Both back still alive. He starts inner vitalizing up. The Sun Strike, not in time. Will not be able to catch him, but looks like they got mid one.
Red Mushi doesn't have a TP.
Soxa, he's gonna be going down, but it's Mushi who's all important right now for Fnatic, but they can't quite save him in left. Maybe DJ, he got pulled back with the relocate, starts healing off the physical damage though. He plays them down. Ohio, he moves on to Weehaw. Desperate for some bashes, he can't get it though. Weehaw, he wins the main fight.
Can you armlet toggle this?
He's into the trees, trying to armlet toggle his way through against two supports, but DJ, he gets the right click. Unbelievable timing there with the urn. Gets the kill, and that makes it a 3-for-4.
And it looked so good in the beginning for DC, but it just took them a little bit too long to take down that Huskar. As that bottom 3-4-3 gonna get gone on, but we not willing to commit with that Wisp still up. Not really sure where he is. Now they're gonna just back out. The big hero to survive here, the Invoker. But still, a successful team fight for Fnatic.
And there is an upside, because that was not a great Chronosphere. It only caught the Invoker. It did not get the Shadow Demon, which meant that there was an immediate disruption. It was basically a very ineffective ultimate from Ohio. It means that these team fights can still go much better for Fnatic, and they can begin to make a comeback. But for now, that fight alone is not going to be enough. The tempo still remains in Digital Chaos's court.
Yeah, and DC, they just weren't able to get any abilities off this move. He got killed quite quickly inside that Chronosphere, even with the disruption.
Man, Misery is getting so damn big.
Yeah, he's starting to develop into a core as he picks up a gem of his own, realizing that they just do not have the vision to play around this. And DC, centered around this Roshan pit, they understand the next Aegis of the game is going to matter quite a lot, as Ohio gonna get spotted out by the Hawk, but he sees it in return.
I mean, they should know Chronosphere is up. Digital Chaos going to still try and do Roshan here, leaving Weehaw inside of the pit. He's gonna be the one man to try and solo up Roshan, but as an Ember Spirit makes his appearance with a sleight of fist, becomes a bit too much for DC. Now Resolution is going to be the one inside the pit. He does have Phantasm ready to go, and they've got BKB charges up as well.
Here comes Fnatic, though, smoked up. Going to lead the way with Ohio. What kind of Chronosphere can you get? As now he's going to start patrolling his Forge Spirits to spot for the smoke.
See if they,
and now he's going to get spotted.
Oh, no. Either way, I don't think Fnatic want to go straight to the high ground area. They're going to try anyway. Jump forward, Ohio. He does
this is the perfect
Ohio
year to go for it.
Relocate on left-hand side. They can actually take out Weehawk. He gets on the BKB, but the pistol damage may still be enough. They take him down. Now Resolution. The immediate buyback alone. Ava is going to be able to come back. Resolution starts going on to Mushi with all those illusions. Pistol damage just seemingly able to overwhelm Mushi. Finally, they get him. The right click comes from Misery. A final cleave from the Kunkka takes out Fnatic. Big carry, and now they have to fully retreat. It costs DC a buyback, but they will be able to take this Roshan now.
Still worth it for them. I think if DC plays this correctly, they can just start going for a push right after the heal. They know that the Chronosphere is down. Weehawk's just going to pick up this Aegis for himself, dropping the drums on the ground. And I don't even think without this buyback, it matters too much. He still has a good amount of items, as now they're going to send Resolution back to heal. Would like to see him drop one of his items to pick up his salve, but they want to continue
Dire's
this push.
Bottom tower is under attack.
With that tier 2 falling now at the bottom lane, Kunkka, Misery is rapidly closing in on a Daedalus. If he wants it, he's got 2,600 gold in the bank right now.
Yeah, he's got an incredible amount of farm, and this boat really did work for DC there as it lands directly on top of DJ, who they really need to kill. 1,400 HP on him. That Ghost Scepter can be quite effective against DC's lineup.
Damage.
Still, Fnatic, it looks like they're okay in team fights. That evasion is incredibly good for Mushi.
Blink Dagger instead for Misery. Better choice for sure, as this means he is an offensive threat to Fnatic at all times. He can blink forward, get the X marks the spot to start pulling these heroes out of position. Conversely, can also X marks the spot himself and blink forward and go for those Tidebringer hits.
Yeah, and Dire gonna scan. They know that there are heroes behind Resolution. That's gonna scare Ohio from making this move. And Weehaw is just invis up. Let's block this move.
Gonna open up. They need to stop to be able to save Midwan. They get the force staff ahead of the Sunstrike, but a tornado comes through. Midwan gonna be cut down.
And 343 also gonna follow suit. He doesn't have that force staff available. Misery right there with the X torrent. And now DC in prime position to go for the push.
They're going to try and wrap around behind the bottom lane, see if they can at least force DJ's relocate, or maybe even get the win.
Ohio up at top, they're going to relocate for this.
Oh, the Chronosphere, they have to relocate inside of the Chronosphere. That's not what they wanted. Resolution pops to BKB in the Phantasm. He's down to half HP. Pursued out. Mushi managed to latch on with the Athlete, but they need the Bastion. They've got it too. Ohio stops the TP out, and now they get pulled back, but no! He brought Mushi! That's not what they wanted, as they already lose the win, and now they're going to catch Mushi as well. It goes from good to terrible for Fnatic, as Mushi cannot fight against four heroes.
And without the Chronosphere available, DC might be thinking about continuing the push, trying to force the buyback on one of the cores. That's exactly what they're going to do. Ohio not in a position to defend without that chrono.
An uncharacteristic mistake from the star support of Fnatic as he pulls Mushi back to that bottom lane. And that leads to Mushi's death. And now Digital Chaos just outside of that bottom lane. Hopefully be able to push for a second lane of Rax. Top goes down, Misery. The support, quote-unquote, Kunkka on the front lines with his heavy amount of damage starts right-clicking the tier 3. Weehawk gonna back him up here. Oh, nice jump forward move. Gonna be able to find Midwan here. They need a save. The poor staff is going to be able to provide a little bit of space. Midwan, he has to jump back to his remnant inside the fountain. And
Octa can immediately get back.
Shadow Demon won't be making it out of the base alive unless the blink. Oh, he stayed ahead of Ohio's right click.
And DC get out of there cleanly. Very good escape by them. And right now, Cap, they have to sense how far ahead they are. All they have to do at this point is take this game very patiently and not lose composure. So far, in their last series, and including this one, they've been able to keep it so far. One last push might be able to topple Fnatic. And DC know that.
This really does feel like a bit of deja vu, Blitz. The last game where Digital Chaos have this big lead, are controlling the map, can just keep a tight grip on the game, but this time around, Fnatic do have some cores that scale a bit better than last time. DC had that late game Slark to be able to employ. Fnatic at least have an Ember Spirits Faceless Void combination that is a terror in the late game.
Yeah, DC, they want to utilize this Aegis. They're going to go for this top tower, the last tier 2 available for Fnatic.
Will they have enough damage to be able to deal with Resolution's push? He's got a BKB, a Vitality Booster. They would love for him to pick up a Heart before they go for the high ground and see if they can just tank through the repeated Sleight of Fist Battle Fury hits from Mid 1's Ember Spirit.
And Fnatic, they're grouping up, but not really looking to fight, as they're going to give this one up for sure. Not really worth risking the game over. Buyback statuses, none of them have it.
Tier 2, for sure going to be given up, as Fnatic will just find a bit of farm and wait for the high ground to push.
And DC, they might not know this, but Fnatic, they don't have buyback on any of their heroes. They cannot afford to lose a single core in this push. DC, though, have that Aegis. Heart's completed now on Resolution. They're going to start beating on this top tower with the Shadow Demon Illusions.
The Disruption Illusions push forward for the Chaos Knight, getting 3 damage onto that tier 3. We've seen this so many times in the tournament. Very little commitment to the high ground push by this team. X marks the spot, Disruption Illusions. Everything is non-committal from DC as they chip away at the tier 3.
They're doing some damage here. At the same time, Mushi gonna get taunted up. Resolution thinking about it, but maybe not the angle that you want to find, especially with no vision onto Ohio. He's gonna be the man to watch.
Fnatic, they need to be able to find an initiation. Eventually, they're just gonna lose their tier 3 and range rack to this constant chip of digital chaos, and that's all up to Ohio to see if he can get the blink forward in Chronosphere. The tier 3 goes down, and DC back away in peace.
Very good deny by Mushi, but that's the best that you can do. Giving up that power as Fnatic, they're not gonna be too pleased about this, as DC gonna continue to poke and prod. You now have buyback available onto this Ember Spirit. And again, maybe if they can find this initiation with Ohio.
Stomp goes down, stalling up the illusion push, but...
Oh, this is range racks. There's no glyph available. They can just continue to poke at this.
Yeah, four spirits and illusions. I've already brought the range racks down to half HP. Fnatic just cannot output enough damage to stop the march of progress. More digital chaos. Now the top opening. Illusion, he starts going on to Mushi. Mushi. Down, half HP, DJ still has the tether in the turnaround, and on the side though, they are going to be able to get the roar out, 3-4-3, going to be soft, Elder Titan, he ends up
with the chrono,
tries to come forward, but he's immediately pushed back and combo, Resolution catches him with the ball, Ohio down for two, and now Mushi, he starts going in, the disruption move will finally be brought down, and they pull him back out, just in time, DJ Sunstrike,
barely doesn't clip him as DC, they still want to go for the push, this heart regen is going to kick in any second now. And Fnatic, they had to commit the buyback to this Ember Spirit. They still have that Chronosphere available. That's what's going to keep DC from going for the push.
DC have been doing a great job keeping aware of their positioning and staying spread out, not allowing Fnatic for a big Chronosphere that could change the fate of this game.
Yeah, this top racks not looking in great shape as DC. They can just keep doing this chip damage game. They're going to wait for their Beastmaster, though, to respawn. They know that this Ember committed the buyback. Weeha has one available now. So if for whatever reason he gets caught out solo by the Chrono, he could even just use the buyback to come back in and maybe cement the fight for his team.
Which is also why he feels comfortable keeping the other lanes pushed in. He starts going for the bottom lane. Now he is going to be spotted out immediately. And maybe this is Fnatic's opportunity to get a pick.
They're thinking about it, but how long will he actually stay there? They have the relocate available, but now he's gone.
There's some wards of DC's very own sitting there. Will be able to spot out the Faceless Void as he tried to press through the trees and catch the invoker. So now it becomes a game of push and pull. Top lane, pulling Fnatic's heroes back up there. And we are going to see DC actually start grouping up at top lane. More disruption pushes. As the melee ranks, it has that natural regen, but it may not be enough with this disruption constantly up from the Shatter Demon and these illusions dishing out so much damage.
And you even had to commit the ultimate from the Huskar just to be able to clear one of them. DC playing this slow, patient game. Absolutely no reason to rush this right now. They are one move away from being able to move on.
Ohio is determined to catch Weehaw when he boots and travels down to the bottom lane, assuming that he's going to do some sort of split push game. He's committing a heavy amount of time here to wait in the trees. But it doesn't seem to be successful. DC making no movement to that bottom lane just yet. Mu just spotted out Roshan. DC, no reason to go for a high ground push if they can get a second life for some of their heroes.
And Wee now shows up at this bottom half, and I think this is just going to mean DC going to go for this free Roshan. Going to try to poke Fnatic outside of their base. And Aegis and Cheese might just be a little bit too much for them to handle. They've got to deal with these illusions and these Forge Spirits first, but they are going to be way too late for this defense for Roche.
Oh, they certainly are. There's just too many threats, too many fires that they have to put out first. They start drawing the line to Roshan, but as they exit their base, Roshan falls, and the Aegis picked up by the Chaos Knight.
And now DC, primed and ready to go for a push again. Fnatic, this combination though, Void plus ET, that could do all the work for them.
They start setting up Digital Chaos, keeping all the lanes pushed in. Will eventually head towards that top lane and go for that melee Rax. We're just about to see Weehaw complete a refresher. He's already had a fantastic game on this Invoker, made some big time plays, and it's only gonna get bigger with two times the spells.
And that's a Bloodthorn now on their Kunkka. This is going to be their option to deal with this Huskar. It gets completely rid of his evasion if they just right-click him down. The silence is going to be very good against all of the heroes on that side of Fnatic, as they have no way to dispel it. And the assault comes in at bottom. Tower's down already.
The last tier 3 finally falls, and already there's an illusion push at top lane. Now the jump 4 by Ohio. He's onto the trees. He's going to be able to get the Chronosphere onto the two supports in the background. They have the reload team coming in from the side as well. They have an Earth Splitter. Will be able to clean both supports in the two. But now Resolution. He tries the meatball with the meatball dropping down on Ember Spirit 10. Breaks him down. Eight with number 2 falls as well. Mushi, he gets pulled back just in time, but they do not have two heroes for a full
meanwhile, Mu at bottom.
Mu helping to be able to snatch up DJ.
Oh, he's just going for the rack.
Now up and top is going to be able to finish Mom. Mu, they're going for the Mega Grease. Mu takes out one rack, and the rest of Digital Chaos take out the other ones. Fnatic have to stand strong against Mega Grease with only 2 cores left.
There's no Ember Spirit buyback. DC, they can sense they're moments away from winning it. They're going to run into Mushi here. Mushi going to be caught. Resolution finds him in the tree, brings him down with his army. Now comes forward Ohio, goes straight for Weehaw, trying to take out threat number 1, but he doesn't stand a chance.
This is the last possible hold from Fnatic.
They're going to have to do it 3-on-3. Mushi comes forward, already jumping onto Weehaw. Weehaw getting off the invis, but now going to be spotted out by the Dust, and they will finally bring the Invoker down. He's dead for 2 minutes, but he has a buyback.
And now DC just trying to get out. It's Mushi going to jump forward.
He's going to be able to find more. Soxa jumped on by the life break. Brought down as well. Only one hero now up from Digital Chaos. The only one to survive through all of that is the Chaos Knight. But there is no possible way for Fnatic to turn and push against DC. They still need their two heroes up for 20 seconds. And there is so many creeps in their base.
And DC, they just lulled Fnatic into this false sense of security. Fnatic, they thought that they had a very good fight. But Mu just runs bottom, goes for the Rax. And while they deal with that, the rest of his team cleans up at top. Very well done by DC. They've kept their composure. They've got Mega Creeps up. All they have to do now is one little push, and Fnatic, they had to commit every single one of their buybacks to be able to defend that.
Digital Chaos have been playing such a beautiful game, leaving nothing to chance, outmaneuvering and outfighting their opponents every step of the way through this lower bracket. And now they are just one very small victory from accomplishing something so huge. Digital Chaos have every advantage you could possibly want heading into the top 3 position. All they have to do is close out the game.
And right now, all lanes, they're trying to push them out. As Fnatic, they're pushing out this mid lane, but the creeps do so much work as DC. They've got buybacks on their cores. I think once this Invoker's up, they just want to start pushing down. Assault Kuros completed on Beastmaster. Not even that needed. Aegis still available on this CK. And now Fnatic, they're going to make their move out.
Pull the blink out. Move. They're not fully grouped up, so he doesn't want to risk a fight. So it looks like they will be able to find Resolution here. Resolution pulling back 3-4-3. He pops his Manta, now gonna be Kronos speared up. Is there gonna be enough damage? Mushi gets cuffed in the back, Mushi goes down. Resolution still alive as well. DJ, he needs to be able to pull these heroes out, but Ohio's already dead.
Two cores down.
Oh no, they're only left with Midwan as the Ember Spirit. How could he possibly stop five digital chaos heroes?
The throne is exposed.
Throne already down to half HP. The Glyph about to run out. And DC, objective full in mind. They're racing to top three.
I cannot believe what's going on right now.
Unbelievable. Digital Chaos. They've made it into the top three.